the talent, the skill set is bar none.
Can't beat that quarterback, Trevor Lawrence.
15-0, going down as the best team ever.
National championship game, 44-16. You tell me what our secondary is about. Throws and it's picked.
Picking the 45-yard line. I mean, our guys had the eye of the tiger.
Looks across the middle, throws it back in the end zone. Pop.
I know 10 years ago, not many people probably saw this coming.
They come to California and strike gold.
There was a lot of talk about best ever all year long.
From the official TV home of the Clemson Tigers family.
But tonight, there's no doubt.
This is 7 News live coverage of Clemson's championship celebration, presented by Granger Nissan.
And you are taking a live look right now from high above Memorial Stadium, better known as Death Valley, for a celebration of champions honoring the 2018 National Champions of College Football.
Of course, the crowds are filling the streets in Clemson on the university campus right now. You can see our traffic camera, which is positioned in the area, of course, where the parade kind of begins. We're talking about College and Keith Street. That's the beginning of the parade. They're going to move on down Highway 93, which comes right behind our location here, where Fred and I are going to be hosting the parade and kind of keeping you up to speed. We're kind of your ringmasters for this show, and it's going to be quite a show. We've got a full team of reporters. We've got Air 7 up in the air, and this is going to be a great time.
That's right. Now, let's see. There's 100 football players on this team, countless numbers of coaches and staff members. We got 5 of us. That's plenty to get this whole thing covered, and we're going to start with Christy Henderson. Good morning, Christy. The weather, it's cold, but we'll take it.
Yes, it is cold. It's about 20 degrees colder than it was this, 2 years ago when we were here for the National Championship Parade. Temperature is right around 38 degrees, but you know what? That has not affected the crowd. Check out the crowd. We have them for the parade, everybody. Woo! It's about to get going here in just a couple of minutes. We got the Tiger Band off to my left that's been warming up. They're number 4 in the parade this morning, and we're going to have a great time. The streets are packed, and this is just the very start of the action. So you can imagine all the people lining the streets all the way down into Memorial Stadium. It is going to be quite a morning to celebrate such an awesome achievement by the Tiger football team. And of course, we got a awesome parade to watch here. They're all lining up behind me. Todd Summers has followed the team from California. He's all the way back here at Clemson, and he's got more on what's going on where he is. Todd?
Christy, thank you very much. We're joined now by one of the legends on this Clemson football team. Back in 2016, you might remember Hunter Renfrow made a catch to win a national championship. He was on the team again this year. When you look back, you've had a little bit of time now. When you look back at your 5 years at this school, is it just way beyond anything that you could have ever imagined?
It is. I mean, it's something that you obviously dream about, but growing up a Clemson fan and being from the state of South Carolina, and just being in middle school, high school, just growing up, loving the school. It's cool to see the change in the culture and see the change in the program. And we weren't winning championships back then, so it's fun to see that too.
Tell me about this senior class, the winningest senior class in the history of college football. You're a big part of that. Obviously, Christian and a lot of those guys are too. But what is it like to be a part of that group of young men?
Yeah, it's unbelievable. It's not just this senior class. It's the whole program. But for this senior class, I think we have 55 wins. But that doesn't happen without the younger guys on this team and the older guys that are here for us. There was a lot that went into it besides just this senior class. And that's what's special to me.
You remember this from 2 years ago. What do you take from the parade, seeing all the fans that maybe couldn't make it out to California, but they can make it out here, and just their love of what you guys have done for them, the joy that you guys have brought to them?
Just the thankfulness and appreciation we have. We have some of the best fans in the country. It doesn't matter if it's a parade like this, they're going to fill the stadium up. And it's just so special to be a part of just a town like Clemson, a school like Clemson, and a community like Clemson. It's pretty neat.
Last question. Tell me what's next for Hunter Renfrow. The people that have seen you in this community for so long, tell me what you do the next couple of months getting ready for the NFL draft and just where you are and what you're doing.
Yeah, just train. I'll be around. I'm Clemson. I'm going to be training at TNT up in Anderson with Jodon Rames. So just kind of getting that ready and really just getting ready for the draft. I'm getting married in April, so getting ready for that. I've kind of had a stillness the last 5 years, and everything's kind of going fast right now, but just enjoying it, taking a stride, and having a lot of fun with it.
Hunter Renfro, thank you very much. I appreciate it as always. He's getting married, and he's getting ready to go to the NFL. That's a pretty good to-do list right there. Let's send it back to the studio, back to the anchors, Amy and Fred.
Yeah, we're right here.
Thanks so much, Todd. Of course, you know, you're talking about Hunter Renfro, and the entire ACC and all of college football are glad that his career is
over.
Finally over, because, you know, he's been killing other teams for years and years, obviously. You're taking a live look right now. You can see it's high above really where this parade is going to start. And again, it's starting at College Avenue and Keith Street. It's taking a little different path than we did 2 years ago. I think you'll actually like it a lot more because you're going to see it go right through the heart of campus.
Well, and what's really cool, one of our interns, Ashley, was telling us, she's a Clemson student. She said, it's so cool that the parade route's going to take these seniors and those who are leaving for the draft right on through the campus again, one last time, you know, so it's kind of a final show through campus to showcase their absolutely awesome achievements. And you can see the band on screen. We've got all kinds of players in this, you know, and it's going to be a lot of fun to hear the band play one more time.
Yeah, you can see that we now have motion. It's underway, as you can see. They're making that left turn onto Highway 93. They're making their way right for our location. If you know the Clemson campus as well, our location right here is front of Sykes Hall. So we're right here at Highway 93 and Calhoun Drive. So we're going to get an early look at this. I can hear my first rendition of Tiger Rag already.
Yep,
from the
here
band.
We go. Everybody's clapping along at home. I know the fans are watching on TV. They're watching right here in person. It's really amazing to see the crowds that have shown up. You know, they estimated last time, Fred, that they might, I think you guys were talking about this during the last parade, 50, maybe 60,000 they thought they'd get. I talked to Tim Beret, who used to be with Sports Information here. He said they got 70, think. So, and he thinks they're going to have more this time. So that's pretty exciting to think about the numbers of people that are going to be here, both on the parade route and later in the stadium.
All right, we want to go back to Todd Summers. We want to talk to more of these players before they get on board these cars and get moving. Let's go to Todd.
Hey, we are live now with Tremaine Ankrum. You've been a part of this team for a while. What does it mean when you come out here and you see the fans line up three and four deep just to get a look at you guys, just to say thanks for all that you've done?
Well, man, it's really a blessing, because you think about it and you just see all the support we get, and that's where our strength really comes from. We're a program that's not anything special. We're just showing what regular people can do when we all come together with a single purpose and support from the community, and great things can happen.
You've had a little bit of time to think about it. How much has it meant to win a national championship two times, to do it twice? I mean, the first time it was maybe a little bit of a shock, but then to back it up with another one.
It just shows how far we've come, man. You know, we've all been working for a single goal, and it's just to be the best we can be. And, you know, in 2016 when we did it, people were a little shocked, but we weren't shocked. We know the work we put in. We know how far we've come. And, you know, to see it come together this year, the way it did, is a beautiful sight.
Outstanding. Tremaine, thank you very much. Let's send it back to Fred and Amy.
So exciting for these players to get a chance to kind of talk with the media one more time, talk with the fans, and we're
awesome.
So glad that
thank
they're allowing the players
it,
to talk to us this year before they get on that float and move their way down the street so we can actually hear from them again. And the folks at home, you know, they won't get to maybe hear everything, and this is great for them to have that opportunity.
That is great. And at the same time, we've also got a lot of fans right around us, and let's head over to the first time to talk to Christine Scarpelli. She's with some of those Tiger fans wearing their orange.
You gotta come over here. Can you believe? Not just fans, in my opinion. I think, and after seeing them practicing out here, guys, I believe you're looking at the next Clemson football team. I don't know, a couple of years down the road, I think these guys are going to be big money for this team. It's going to be so exciting. All right, we got JW out here. We're so glad to have you. What are you guys doing in the morning? It's early.
Yeah, well, usually we just show up, we unpack our stuff, we get a little food, we eat, and then we start a football game.
Right.
Every 5 minutes or so,
we've
got different people joining. You've never met these people. You don't know how they're going to play.
You're not all buddies?
No. I mean, some of us, like, these are all my friends. I know them.
Very
but
good.
Some people, like Joe over here,
hey,
I just met. Joe and Mason.
Hey, Joe. Nice to meet you. You practicing out here?
Yeah.
Very cool. Now, parade, very close, you guys. You can see just down the road a little bit. They're on their way. They're coming. Are you excited? What are you excited to see?
The Tigers.
I mean, that is a great answer.
Yeah, but I think I've missed this since 2016. Yeah. I was really hoping we'd get this 2017.
Last year.
Yes,
right?
Ma'am, but that didn't happen. So 2018, 2019 season, team coming down the road to see is pretty exciting and amazing to see just in general.
Cause I love it. Now, you guys all wearing orange, right? I got a couple hats out here. Very good. Any particular players you're excited to see?
Well, my friend, his dad works for a football facility, so I get to go see some of the players. I know Tanner Muse very well.
Okay.
I can tell you now, he eats a lot of food.
He
eats everything. He loves food. Yeah, I don't need
you guys could have a competition, maybe. I don't know.
He'd win.
Okay.
But
maybe we'll set that up out here, guys.
Yeah, I get to see a whole bunch of the players doing different things around the facility.
Wow,
they like to do.
Well, listen, you guys, good luck with your practice. Can I get a cheer? Maybe just to see how loud you guys can get as we... All right, maybe out. 3, 2, 1.
Woo! 1, 2, 3.
We're just practicing for when the parade goes by. Just trying to show them what we got out here. All right, guys, we'll send it back to you.
Not only did we get some great information, we know much more than we ever did about Tanner Muse's dietary habits.
Yeah, Tanner's like, the truth is out now. I eat a lot. There you go. Well, hey, if you're a football player and you're a national champion, you need to train hard.
So
some of that is the eating that's involved, right? It's all a big part of the equation. That's awesome. Well, we, of course, have the band still continuing to roll down the streets. We've got a huge crowd behind us, and this is where the parade's going to take the turn and head on down Calhoun Drive and head toward Memorial Stadium. So it's really exciting to get them almost to our location.
You can tell how big a deal this is becoming right now because our location, we're across the street from where they're building the new business school.
That's right.
Here at Clemson. This is, you might remember the old Clemson House location.
Sure.
They're actually doing construction this morning. We could hear the saws and everything blaring.
And the beep, beep, beeps.
Before we got here. They've stopped. They're watching the parade now.
Yes.
I hope I didn't bust them to the boss, by the way, by letting them know. But give them a few minutes to watch this because it doesn't happen that often, although it's beginning to happen more frequently
at Clemson.
It sure is. With two national championships in the last 3 years.
Yeah, everybody's wondering what's next for Clemson, right? With the we're losing some key players, but we also have some really great young talent on this team. And so it's going to be exciting to see what the Justin Rosses and Trevor Lawrences do down the road.
Yeah. One of the things that happened in that game against Alabama on Monday night, every Clemson touchdown was scored by someone either running it, catching it, returning an interception, or throwing it. They were all freshmen and sophomores.
Wow.
So, I mean, there is an incredible amount of talent. They're losing this tremendous senior class. Again, 55 wins for these seniors. But they got a lot more in the system coming up.
It's exciting times in Clemson. Oh, and I think the beeps behind us tell the story, right? The parade is just about at our location, getting ready to make the turn.
Exactly. So we got our first action come up behind us. We can see the flags coming over my left shoulder. So we're going to have the band up close for us very, very soon, which will be a lot of fun. And again, the aerial view. It's cloudy right now. But at the same time, it's a nice morning. I know it's a little bit chilly. We also want to show you the parade route because it's going to be a little bit different because you're going to be going on Calhoun Street toward Hill Street.
Clemson police leading the way. The EMS crews as well right behind us. So it's fun to see them kind of, hey, guys. We've got young Tigers in the front seat cockpitting their way through.
We're getting our first look at it now.
The Dobulence, get it?
Very
nice. Like Dabo, that's cute. Instead of ambulance, very nice.
Got the flag corps coming through. And we're going to go ahead and while we watch this up close, Todd Summers is with another member of this national championship team.
Large member of this national championship team, defensive lineman Albert Huggins. Albert, talk about how your role changed when the regular season ended and then the college football playoffs began and how you responded to that challenge stepping in for Dexter Lawrence.
You know, man, just an opportunity came along and I took advantage of my opportunity. I was so thankful for it, man. And, you know, I just, like I said, I took advantage of it. And, you know, I felt like I did great.
Tell me about your ride. You came in here as a highly touted guy from the state of South Carolina, and maybe it took you a little while to get up to speed, but then where you are now compared to where you were when you got here as a freshman?
Oh, man, you know, it was coming out of high school, man. You know, I thought I was that guy, and, you know, coming to Clemson, it humbled me a lot. And, you know, I had faith, and I stuck with it. And, you know, it paid off for me, and I'm just thankful I stuck here. I stayed here.
Tell me about this fan base, what this community, what a national championship means to them, what you've heard the last couple of years when you won it, what you've heard since you've won it this time, just how important football is to this community.
It's very important, man. We got great supporters. You know, when we was coming back from California on the way here, people was at the airport. And then when we got here, when we got to the facility, there was a whole group of fans out there supporting us. And the same thing from when we first won the national championship, it was the same thing. It was a group of fans out there supporting us. The parking lot was packed. They couldn't even drive out of the parking lot. So we have great fans, and I'm glad they support us like they do, and go Tigers.
All right, Howard Huggins, thank you very much. There's a young man that took advantage of his opportunity on the big stage, and now he's getting ready to see what his pro prospects are as well. Let's send it back to Fred and Amy.
We should start dancing, clapping, something, because we've got the band right behind us, and they are doing a great job. Let's listen.
Really is. Obviously, you recognize the song Tiger Reg, and of course, they are literally marching their way to Death Valley right now, which means they're going to be really familiar with their favorite song as they reach a new audience every few steps.
They sound great. Wow, they sound terrific. It's really loud when they're right next to you. So we were letting you guys listen for a moment because we can't hear each other.
Yes.
But that was fabulous. We had a little tiger that showed up in the middle of us, too. It was really cute. This is a great location because we really can see the crowd, the band, the feeling that this is. It's not Disney, but it's kind of close. You know, when you're this into it, when these fans are so happy and excited, there's kind of a really fun spirit here today that everybody's
really
enthused.
They're about three or four deep. We got the rally cats and the cheerleaders behind us right now. They're doing what they do best, and that's getting all these people fired up. I mean, it's a sea of orange out here.
Woo! I knew the woo was coming.
Yeah.
The woo always comes.
A sea of orange coming for sure. But again, all to honor this championship team, winning it for the second time in 3 years. Last 4 years, all in the college football playoff, played for the national championship 3 times, and now up in this epic battle against Alabama 2-1.
All right, we want to get back to our Todd Summers. He keeps hunting down the best players to talk to, so let's see who Todd has now. Hey, Todd.
Hey, we are joined now by starting middle linebacker Kendall Joseph, who's from the upstate. He's a Belton guy. What does it mean to this community when you look at these streets lined up? You're a part of this community. You were a kid cheering for the Tigers. What does it mean to do what you've done the last couple of years?
The Tiger tail.
It's just great. It's a great honor, you know, to be able to make these people proud and the fans proud. And, you know, it's just like one of the best football little cities in America. And just to be able to, you know, bring back a championship to Clemson is awesome.
Tell me about doing the parade 2 years ago. What do you remember from that?
I just remember kind of just being just, I don't know, just smiling the whole day, like just kind of just taking it with the wind and being so excited to be a part of something like this because it's so historic. And we was able to make it happen twice now.
You've had a couple days now to let it soak in. When you look back at your career, how do you put into words what you've been able to accomplish? Is it more than you could have ever dreamed? A couple of national championships, 4 ACC titles. You're leaving this place way better than you found it.
Yeah, it's, you know, only God could do it. I feel like I could have never dreamed of having such a great career, you know, and I'll just remember the friendships I made, the relationships I made with people and my teammates, and this last 5 years for me is something that I'll cherish for the rest of my life.
Is that part of what makes this so special, is that the relationship you guys have, it's not a forced relationship. Mm-hmm. You guys genuinely like each other. How does that transition onto the field?
Oh, it's everything, you know, because you got to have love for your teammates, love for your brothers, and these guys, I mean, it's so much deeper than football, and, you know, I think that's what makes us a great football team, and I think you see it when you watch us play football on TV, you know, you just see it, a joy and excitement and just and happiness for seeing your brothers excel.
Kendall Joseph, thank you very much, as always. What a career this guy had. He's taken a couple of national championships and 4 ACC titles with him as he takes on the next step of getting ready for the NFL. Let's send it back to you, Fred and Amy.
All right, thank you, Todd. one of the really cool things about this parade is happening right now, because they've got former players from decades going back to the 70s and earlier. The class of the 80s are walking behind us. These are players. Now, some of them were on the 1981 National Championship team.
Yep.
Some of them played on ACC title games. But it's great to see players who were involved in this program for many, many years before this current run of a major success has started. It's great that they got to be involved.
Well, and this is the whole point, right? The whole Clemson family concept that Dabo Swinney has really championed is a reality. I mean, he included all the former players last time. They're back again this time. And it's a true celebration of this Clemson community they've created. They call it the Clemson family.
Absolutely. Well, Christine Scarpelli, of course, with us. Christine, what's going on now?
Hey, guys. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. So many cool things. So we just saw the band go by, and I thought that was really neat. And then I turn around, and we have a band jacket and a band member, I'm told, from several years ago. So you played for the Clemson band. What's your name?
My name's Luis Garcia.
Luis, nice to meet you. And did your wife play as well?
Yes, you
did. Deneen Garcia.
Deneen.
When did you play?
From 79 to 83.
Wow, you guys. And what did you play?
Saxophone.
Wonderful. And?
Flat core.
Well, this is amazing. We just saw them go by. What's it like being in a parade? Is that, you know, tough? Is it different than playing maybe at halftime?
It's just an inline walk for a lot, forever and ever.
Forever and ever. Well, and did you have to play? I mean, you had to.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The Miami parade was about 7 miles long. We ended up, you know, cutting it short a little bit, but it was hot. But it was fun.
Yeah, and you, I mean, that's exerting a lot of physical activity through the whole time.
Oh, yeah. We didn't have to work out any more than we did for the band, because that was enough.
Way more than the gym. I give you two a lot of credit. What years did you play?
I played from 1980 to 1983.
Wow. We just saw the 80s alumni go by as well. What years?
79 to 83.
Wow. You guys, that's such a neat perspective, I think, especially just watching them go by. Was it exciting for you guys to see the big win?
Oh, very much so. I mean, we were there in 81 when we beat Nebraska for the first championship, and now we watch the other two. It's great.
I am so glad you're here, because there are so many excited people here along with you guys. So great to talk to you. I'll probably send it back to our anchors now, because you guys are doing a great job seeing so much going by. What have you seen lately you've liked?
We just saw, like you did, the 1981 championship team, and that you can hear the cheers that are going on for them as they make their way down toward Memorial Stadium.
Isn't it cute?
Yeah, 1981's a little bit more towards my era, and we look a little older these days, to be honest with you, but they look good. It was great to see them out there as we've got more members of the alumni going through. Some are getting good rides. There's Jim Clements, of course, the Clemson president, in a
president
beautiful orange Camaro. Going right by us. And let's send it right now to Christy Henderson.
I refuse to drive like this.
All right, Fred and Amy. Yeah, we got a good crowd here. Of course, we've seen the coaches, kids, tracks go on by. We're still seeing all kinds of, hearing all kinds of cheers as well. And I've got one kid here, right here. This is Jude. How you doing, Jude?
Doing good. How are you?
Good. This is your first parade. What do you think so far?
I think this is awesome.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Who are you looking forward to seeing as far as the players go, or anybody in particular?
I was hoping that Deshaun would be here from the 2016.
Did you see the 2016 team went by as well as the 81? Did you see him?
Yeah.
Good. And how about any players from this year's team? Any that you want to see in particular?
Probably Trevor Lawrence or Renfro.
I'm sure a lot of people are in your court. And I love your glove. It's chilly out here, right? We got 30s, so people aren't letting the cold get to them. I've got a glove, but you got a tiger paw. And that's what you should have for today. Thanks, dude.
Go Tigers! All right.
Yeah!
With you and live in Clemson as we watch on the university campuses this celebration unfold right behind us. And I got to tell you, the crowds here, when you think about what happened at the stadium, you were there in California. There were so many Clemson folks that traveled all the way out there, and even more of them here.
Yeah, it's a huge crowd. Meanwhile, let's go real quick to Todd Summers, because we got to get at least one more player before they start moving.
Fred, this isn't just any player. This is the defensive MVP from the national championship game, Trayvon Mullen. Trayvon, tell me about, why were you so calm and cool and prepared on the biggest stage of your life to have the game you did, an interception, a sack, and you just played a complete football game against Alabama?
I mean, maybe because I prepare. I know what I want. I know what I want the end result to be. Prepare well with the team. I had a Zoom focus during that week. Coming from Notre Dame, but I knew we had a short week, and I knew we was playing a tough opponent. So I know I had to be locked in and be prepared as I can be.
What has it been like, the attention you've gotten the last couple days?
I mean, it's been awesome. I feel like I deserve it, but I'm going to continue to grind and get better and try to work.
Last question, what does this parade mean to you guys, the guys on the team, to see the people that couldn't go to California that came out here to support you?
It means a lot. It just shows the type of culture that we have, and we all love our fans. We preach that a lot. Coach Sweeney, he never forgets about the fans, so it means it's a big deal to us.
Awesome. Trayvon Mullen, thank you very much. Appreciate it. They are starting to line up the players and get them out there. I just saw Brent Venables go by on a float. The players aren't too far behind. Let's send it back to you, Fred Namey.
Thank you, Todd. Of course, Trayvon Mullen, Clemson fans will get to continue to cheer him on.
That's right.
He is going to be in the NFL draft coming up in April, and obviously he'll be playing in the big leagues next year.
It's fun to watch them go on and do their next thing. Deshaun Watson, of course, has been around out in California, and he's here today, and it's exciting to see these players come back and celebrate their team and honor the accomplishments of their Clemson family.
Yeah, you mentioned Deshaun Watson. Mike Williams was there. DeAndre Hopkins was there. And we had a chance to see all of them out there at California on the field after the game. They want to be there. And there's somebody you know pretty well. There's Dabo Sweeney. What
oh,
a job he's done. He's already stolen someone's camera to
wow.
do some of his own coverage.
That's awesome.
This is a guy who's not on social media, but he should be. He acts
yeah,
like it.
He sure does. And, you know, the players stay off social media all season of their own volition. They agreed to do this on their own. They decide it's a distraction they want to keep out of their lives to focus on the football. And then as soon as that win happened, they were posting. Right now, all you see is Clemson players
yeah.
posting on social media.
That's something they've been doing for the last several years. It was something the player done to get rid of those distractions and that kind of thing. Hunter Renfro is someone you're looking at. Hunter Renfro, big time back on Twitter and,
yeah,
and Instagram
right
after, in the moments after the national
yep.
championship game. They could all find their phones very quickly.
And so we're seeing the team captains coming along, which is
hey,
Christian
awesome Wilkins.
To see. And we're also seeing some of the personnel, the staff that makes the football strategy work, right? They train these players and work with them and do the team building that it takes to create what has been this decade-long pursuit of national championships.
They've done it with so many ways. They've had so much great staff, stability, so many guys who are involved in this program actually played at Clemson and are yeah. still part of this. I think they've had five of their assistant coaches have been with this team since 2012.
That's impressive.
In college football, that's incredible. I think seven since 2014, so that's a remarkable run of success to have that kind of stability. Once again, the theme
family.
You're kind of talking about, the Clemson
yeah.
family.
Yep. You stick around when your family's involved, don't you?
Yes.
Or actually, sometimes you don't. But hopefully you do. And this is definitely a very cohesive family. They are making it Roll Away Tide. This lady has a sign behind us that says Roll Away Tide. We had a lot of roll tears, roll, and yeah.
Yeah, right now we've got another big flatbed 18-wheeler
yeah,
going behind us.
The big flatbeds usually tell the story of the football players coming pretty soon, right?
Yes. They're just starting to get on board their cars, and I know that there might be more of a rush on Trevor Lawrence when he goes by us than he felt
That's
against Alabama the other night.
Float that just went behind us, the football recruiting operations. There's a whole division for that, and they are fully staffed today on that float. Ready to go.
Yeah, give the football operations staff so much credit because, you know, they had to travel across the country, and not many of them flew, driving trucks and vehicles across the country. And that's going to Dallas for the Cotton Bowl and then all the way 2,500 miles to San Jose and Santa Clara
yeah,
for the national
staff.
Championship game.
They're really doing a lot of heavy lifting for this team.
Well, Todd Summers once again joins us on the streets of Clemson. Hey, Todd.
Hey, Fred, we are now walking the parade route. You are looking at Kendall Joseph and Mitch Hyatt, and they are just having a blast. These fans are just giving them all kinds of love. Look at that smile on Kendall Joseph. He's worked really hard for this moment, and Cleland Furl is certainly enjoying the moment as well. You can see him on top of this Jeep with Adam Choice, the senior running back. Look at his smile. Look at, he's dancing, he's having a good time, he's waving. I mean, there is so much energy with this parade and these fans. And you know what, Fred and Amy, these guys have earned this moment. This is their chance to celebrate and enjoy. Nobody sees how hard they work for them to be national champions, but they do see on this parade route how much fun they have as well. And Dabo Swinney talks all the time about the fun is in the winning. And these guys are having a lot of fun as well. Let's send it back to you guys.
At the end of the season and do the best you can do, but also this is like the icing on that cake, right? Getting this, the appreciation of your fans and the celebration right here at home in this place that's kind of groomed you and grown you for 4 years. It's really special.
Yeah. Once again, if you're just joining us, this is the Clemson Championship Celebration. It's really just kind of getting going right now. You saw where some of those players are. They're still back on Keith in college. So they're just getting moving. So there's a lot of parade for you to go as we make our way to Death Valley. And, of course, there's going to be a huge rally and presentation there. And you're going to see all that live right here on 7 News.
Yeah, 7 News is so proud to be the official TV sponsor and home of the Clemson Tigers family. And so it's a really great fit for us to be Carolina's family and part of the Clemson family, too. This is a really, really fun time for the station. And we really celebrate with the Clemson team. This is a really big thing for the state. I mean, this has impacts for the whole region and for this community as a whole in the town of Clemson. So for all of the upstate, really, this is a big win.
Yep. I think Christy Henderson is standing by, if we can get to her. Excuse me, Christine Scarpelli. We got a Christine. We're going to Christine this time.
Oh, this is so much fun. I love it. I'm happy to be anything close to a Christy. So I love it. There you go. Listen, look, we got a lot to show you here. So we got the coaches' families, which is exciting. And we got some alumni. I got to show you. I got to introduce you to Allison. I love it here. And we've got Olivia as well. You've got a couple fans with you, but you guys went to Clemson back in
97.
Same. Around that area, 97. You got to give a wave. What do you guys think of the parade so far? Has it been fun?
I love the parade. The parade is so much fun.
The band is the best.
You like the band? Okay. Yes. Very good. You know, you probably hear these songs all year long. The band plays them, but hearing them at a parade is just that much more celebratory, right?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Kiddos, is this fun for them to see? Yes. Were they excited?
Yes, they're loving it. Yes.
What do you think of the parade so far?
What
do you think of the parade?
I like it.
You like it. Hey, that seems to be the consensus around here, guys. We've got so much more to show you. We'll continue to hang out with the fans out here, but the consensus so far is that the parade, very cool, very enjoyable, and you would say, what do you think, worth getting up for?
Absolutely. Right.
There you go. That's the report from the field. We'll send it back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Christine. As we continue to see, again, we're at 93 in Calhoun, so they're making the turn right by us. We saw the football equipment staff going by us a few moments ago. They had no lack of enthusiasm, and we've seen a variety of cars. I love that we saw very briefly, and you might see him again before we're done, Jim Clements, the president. I bet he had the pick of his car, because if there was any car I'd want, I want that old orange Chevy Camaro he's riding in right now.
It's so cool. The cool cars that they found for the coaching staff and some of the fun orange vehicles, the Jeeps and things that they've reconfigured for Clemson celebration. It's really been a lot of fun to watch this all come together. You know, they had to put this together in such a short period of time. But having done it once before so recently, I mean, they've done it twice before, but I was talking to somebody who was here in 81, and they said, you know, for example, the celebration that was in the streets the evening after, or the evening of the win, was actually a police response, you know, because they only had like 3,000 kids left on campus at that point. They all went downtown. The cops had to be called, whereas this time they clear the streets. They have 15,000+ folks down there having a good time watching the game together. So it's really changed. They learned how to do this, and it's going so smoothly today.
Yeah. Of course, one of the things that changed for that 81 game was that it was played on New Year's night. So
right.
They knew New Year's night before everybody was able to get back on campus. So this time you got classes that started back up earlier this week, and now everybody can be here to enjoy this parade. We're going to go back to Todd Summers, who's close to somebody right now that I think is going to have everybody in college football's attention for at least two more years.
Look at the front of this float right here. You see Trevor Lawrence. He's waving to the crowd as we speak. That is your national championship game offensive MVP. And why do you have a feeling that maybe he's going to be in another parade someday? Maybe he's going to be in another parade for the Tigers. Maybe he's going to be in another parade wherever his NFL team is in a couple years. But when he went by, the fans were going crazy. And he'll be coming your way here shortly, Fred. Amy, back to you.
We're just saying hello to all the coaches as they come by, kind of waving and greeting as they roll on. Tony Elliott, the co-offensive coordinator there. Yeah. Hey, Tony. So we got lots of people behind us, and they're rolling on the streets of Clemson and Clemson University right now with the firefighters. Everybody is part of this event. The whole town has jumped in to celebrate.
I'm going to stop and take a couple of pictures myself, because right now, passing behind us is the coaching staff, the offensive coordinator, Tony Elliott, and his family just went by us. Jeff Scott, the co-offensive coordinator, just went by. Brent Venables is making his way towards us right now. He's riding in the back of a GTO, so he did pretty well. Yeah, we're armed with our phones.
We're sitting here ready.
We're like you.
We're
fans.
Just like
we're
you
this
guys.
Close. We're going to take a couple of pictures. But again, Brent Venables passing behind us right
Here's
now.
Hey,
the
Brent.
Architect of that defense that took on Notre Dame and Alabama and held them to a combined 19 points, including the Crimson Tide, shutting them out over the game's final 44 minutes.
And of course, the chopper is overhead. We got Air 7 up today for you to make sure you can get that perspective of just how big the crowds are, how many people are here, and how much fun folks are having. It really gives you a sense of just amazingly how the crowds are, how the fans are responding, and pretty much all you can hear is screaming in the streets of Clemson and Clemson University right now.
Yeah, I got to be honest, it was hard to hear what you were just saying because Dabo Swinney and his ride just went right behind us, and man, that's the loudest cheer we've had so far, and we've had a lot of them so far.
Yep, I think when Trevor makes the turn here, it's going to get crazy.
I love it. Christian Wilkins is sporting the victory cigar right now as he's riding alongside Hunter Renfro. Actually, some of these players are smoking cigars right now. I'm sure that this is more than likely hopefully an open smoking area on campus. Otherwise, I think they won't mind just that they
yeah they probably
just
get a little wiggle room
special occasion
a little wiggle room
so
for these guys.
Break.
So we've got a lot of the big players here. We've
Again,
got
the team moving behind us.
Barrel of choice. We've got big trucks with big players coming behind them as well. Boy, it's kind of a little nerve-wracking to see those big rigs come so close right behind us. Wow.
Yeah. 18-wheeler coming behind
come,
us. It's
champions.
Got a bunch of these players right now as they're moving behind us.
Wave.
So.
I'm telling them, wave, guys. You're on TV.
We get one little bit of a break where we are because for these big wheel trucks, it's a little bit of a hairpin turn, so they have to kind of pause for a moment when they go by us. So that's bonus opportunities
Bye.
For everybody.
Hey, guys.
When they have this parade next year, think about spotting yourself here.
It's got a... Everybody's got a beverage. There you go.
But again, everybody making their way right now. They're turning onto Calhoun. They're heading to Fort Hill, and then that will then take them down the hill to Memorial Stadium at Death Valley, and they'll get to go down the hill one more time, at least for this season, and, of course, the huge, big production to come that's going to be fun to watch.
Of course, we say hello to all those in the stadium who are watching the parade because there is a lot of folks that are in the stadium right now who are enjoying the coverage of the parade coming to them from 7 News. So we say hello. Hello, stadium. Hope you all are having a good time. Hello.
If you don't mind, if we turn our heads right here, I think these are some of the guys on the defense that are making their way behind us.
Good job, guys.
Again, that defense, one of the best in the country. go ahead and take a look right now from our
They've got their undefeatable newspapers. They're holding them up. Undefeatable. There you go.
So you can, and you get a real good look right there. I mean, in some parts of the campus, they're 5 and 6 deep. Holding up some of those newspapers again, pointing out, yeah, unbeatable. The first 15-0 team in at least modern college football history. 15-0 national champions.
Since the 1800s, that is.
1897 was the last team that did it. It was it was Penn.
Yep.
Football was a little different back then.
I bet so.
By the way, I read up a little bit on that team. They were 15-0. They played 13 of their 15 games at home. And one of their opponents, Yale, accused them of using adult players. They said they used players that were up to 30 years old against college kids. So maybe put an asterisk, if you wish, against that 15-0 Penn team of 1897.
Wow, impressive. So things have changed just a wee bit in the modern era of football.
I believe we got some of the offensive players right now. And again, what a performance.
I think we're getting ready. There he is, the main man.
Not only the Cotton Bowl, the national championship game. As you take a live look right now, there is Dabo Swinney. I love that he's wearing like a Clemson letter jacket today. He's kind of more one of the gang this year, as opposed to maybe he had that official suit and tie look last year. And you also get a nice look at Trevor Lawrence right there.
Great shot of Trevor. Nobody can see Trevor enough at this point because people are really talking about him. He is just a superstar. And my favorite story that Todd did with him was that story where Trevor Lawrence was as cool as a cucumber. He's like, does anything excite you? And he's like, no, I'm a cool, easygoing guy. And that's, I think, his key to his success, you know?
I think the word is unflappable. At least that's one of the words that you can use for him. And again, you're getting a great look at Dabo Swinney during a little bit of a pause in this parade right now. That bright orange letter jacket that he is wearing.
Well, they're just
and again, we can't wait to see once we get to the stadium. There's a lot of people right now in Death Valley who have been there since the gates opened at 7 o'clock. They are watching the parade, our coverage right now on Paw Vision. And the parade right now is coming to them, so they'll have a good seat for the entire ceremony to follow.
Yeah, we'll slowly start to see the folks that have been in the parade get off of their various vehicles, out of vehicles, and then they will head into the stadium, and we'll start to see that sort of marching in process. So you'll see all those former players come in, and the crowds at the stadium start to really appreciate them. And I think once you get Trevor Lawrence gone, the crowd's starting to move out, isn't it?
Let's go ahead and join Todd Summers. He's near the head coach.
Hey, Fred, you are looking at Dabo Swinney, his wife, Kathleen, and his youngest son, Clay, because the other two boys, Drew and Will, are with their respective freshman and sophomore classes on one of those floats. Dabo is absolutely soaking this up. He is absolutely loving this. You got to remember, back when he took this job, nobody believed this was possible, but Dabo had a vision that this was possible. He thought that this team, that this program was on the right track and that great things were ahead. He said 10 years ago, he said, we were about to have the best decade in Clemson football history. Nobody believed him. You look back at it now, it's been the best decade in Clemson football history. These guys are having a good time. Dabo right now is saying, what's up? You having fun? You earned this. This is awesome. This is fantastic.
Hey, it's cold, it's early, nobody cares. Look at this crowd.
It's not raining?
It's unbelievable. Not raining.
Let's do this again next year.
Let's do it.
Dabo Swinney having some fun. He loves cameras too. I don't know if you knew that or not, Fred. He loves cameras too. Let's send it back to you guys.
Oh, gosh. Oh, it's great that we got a moment with Dabo there. That's fantastic. And people are really thrilled for him and his family and this larger Clemson family.
Yeah. I don't think he's ever kind of lost that kid. I believe he's 49 now. You can't tell by his looks. You can't tell by the way he acts. We had a snowstorm a year or two ago, and it was during a weekend where they had some recruits here, and they actually did sledding down the hill, and Dabo Swinney was right in the middle of them, going down the hill with him.
He's a kid at heart, somewhere under it all, right? So Christine Scarpelli, of course, is keeping up with the fans as they take the parade in. Christine, who are you talking to?
Trying to.
You guys, first of all, this is hysterical, seeing the players on the bleachers, on the semi-trucks. What a sight to see. I think it's just such a great way to put them up. You guys enjoy seeing them. Is this a fun thing for you guys to do?
It's unbelievable. I mean, you know, it's a beautiful day, perfect day for a perfect season celebration. You know, we were 3-8 my freshman year, and we've lost none this year. You know, it's unbelievable where we've come and how much this program's changed the whole university, I think. So it's a special day. Excited to be here.
Introduce yourself to all of our viewers, and you did go to Clemson.
I did. Class of 2001, and I think we've got about 15, 16 degrees throughout our family, so this place is in our blood. My name is Nick Schumacher. Up from Charleston with the family to watch the parade. So.
Traveling all the way up here, was it worth it?
Yeah, you know, absolutely. A couple years ago, I didn't know if we'd ever see this again. Now I'm wondering how long it'll be till the next one.
Well, will you come back if they win again?
We're psychos about this. We'll be back.
Yeah, psychos for Clemson. I think that's a pretty good idea. I love it. Now everyone is as excited as these guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is just such a ball. I just love seeing them. Of course, you had the Clemson Fire Department up here. We were looking at lots of law enforcement out here as well, guys. We've been seeing just making sure everybody's safe. Highway Patrol as well. So big thank you to them. But everybody kind of clearing out. They're headed to the stadium, guys, because we've got to go see and hear everybody talk. So we'll send it back to you.
That's absolutely true. And as we take a look from Air 7 over the top of the Clemson Stadium, we're looking with Air 7's help at just how many folks are in there filling that lower bowl.
Yeah, and really right now you're only seeing one side. They are on both sides of it, and they are just beginning to kind of make their way. This is a kind of a cool thing. You know, most parades, you go and get your spot, and then you go home.
Yeah.
But here's like you get your spot, you watch them go by, and then you kind of make
get
your way.
Get your new spot.
To a new spot. We're going to spot B.
Spot
Maybe
B,
some families were really, really industrious and had seats reserved.
Yeah.
Okay, you save us in the stadium and we'll save them out here.
Yeah, that's pretty funny. Yeah, strategic planning for the Clemson celebration. Well, let's talk a little bit about that gentleman saying he came from Charleston. We met somebody at the gas station on the way down from the upstate who had come in from Charlotte. The kids and the family had gotten up at 4 a.m. to do that, and they were the kids were talking about how they got a nap in the car. The poor parents didn't.
Yeah,
but they were all in. They were all ready to go and have a great time.
You can kind of see the setup right there, that huge orange stage. That's where the team will be. The goalpost will be behind them, and the podium will be at the front. And you'll hear obviously from Jim Clemens, the school president. You'll hear from Dan Radakovich, the athletic director. You'll hear from Dabo Swinney. You'll hear from a lot of the stars, especially the senior stars. And again, Death Valley beginning to fill up right now. And yeah, it might be like 38 or 39 degrees. It doesn't feel like it there.
No, and I think that Todd is still seeing a lot of folks coming by, including some of the coaches. So Todd, why don't you fill us in on who you're seeing?
Yeah, Amy, what we're going to do is we're going to do a walk of the assistant coaches right now as we walk along. We see Lemansky Hall. He is a defensive ends coach. This is the first time he's done this parade as one of their on-field assistant coaches. We keep on coming down. We see defensive tackles coach Todd Bates. He's relatively new to the staff as well. And you can see the fans just lined up cheering as we go along. This is Mickey Kahn, the safeties coach. He's with his family. He's waving and having a good time as well. And as you kind of go down the line, you see Mike Reed, the defensive backs coach. He's there with his family, smiling, having a good time. Next up is the quarterbacks coach, Brandon Streeter. He's a big reason why you've seen Trevor Lawrence have the success that he has had. He's been a fantastic mentor for the quarterbacks on this Tigers football team. The offensive line coach, Robbie Caldwell. The reason these guys are so good at protecting Trevor Lawrence is because Robbie Caldwell's been doing this for a long, long time. We keep on coming down the line. We see tight ends coach, special teams coach, Danny Pierman. He's waving at the camera. We're moving a little bit closer. Now we see co-offensive coordinator Tony Elliott and his young family having a good time. They are all smiles as well. Here's Jeff Scott. Both these guys, former players as well. He's with his young daughter and his family having a good time at the parade. Next up is Brent Venables and his family. Now his oldest son, Jake, is back on the float because he's a part of this football team, but the rest of his family is in this car as well. And finally, the last of the coaches is head coach Dabo Swinney. He is all smiles as well. Obviously, they're missing two of their family members, but that's because they're now part of the team as well. And if you look a little bit further back, you see Christian Wilkins with a box of Krispy Kreme donuts. He's throwing them to the crowd. You gotta think, Christian Wilkins is having the time of his life. He just took a bite of a donut and then threw it into the crowd. Maybe we'll see that donut on eBay or something later. Let's send it back to you, friend Amy.
Oh, man. Now we're selling food on eBay. It will sell for some big money. That's hilarious.
That's great. I just love him.
Christian
Wilkins ate this Krispy Kreme.
Yeah, he's hilarious. When he came by, unfortunately, we weren't on camera, but he mugged for us. And he was like, woo, trying to make a funny face. He's hilarious.
He has been such a fun player. Not only a great player, but just so much fun. He's a loose guy. With the week that Trevor Lawrence became the starting quarterback, he took him out to breakfast to say, like, you know, you're our guy, you're our leader. He did some teaching in one of the local, I think, elementary schools. Uh-huh. Can you imagine a guy that size teaching elementary kids and doing a great job? He is just going to be missed, not only for his play, but just the kind of guy he is.
Well, when you think about the academic accomplishments of this team, Dabo Swinney talked about it when they won, you know, in his news conference, how proud he was of this is a team that has done a lot on the football field, but it's done a lot academically, and their grades are fantastic, and it speaks a lot for, like, what they put into the program and how they try to really make it a full academic athletic experience.
Yeah, Wilkins earned his degree in less than 4 years, so just another just incredible accomplishment. Right now you're taking just another look at the captains as they make their way, as they get closer, as they were taking Calhoun Drive. If you know the campus, they're going to Fort Hill, and then they'll make their way down the hill. There's another nice close shot of Hunter Renfro, of course the hero of the national championship game 2 years ago when he caught that pass from Deshaun Watson with just 1 second to go to beat Alabama. And there's, of course, Christian Wilkins, one of the stars of that defense that shut out the Crimson Tide for the last 44 minutes of Monday night's game. Again, Clemson fans waited so long. It was 1981 to 2016.
That's a long wait.
And now, 2 years later, here they are again, and the potential for more is there.
Absolutely. And, of course, a win like this, and you can speak to this, Fred, really helps with the recruiting, right? I mean, you start having national championships back-to-back. Sometimes, you know, people say, oh, they got one, it's a fluke, you know, good for them. But now it's no fluke, folks. This program is working. So kids want to be part of that.
Yeah, they really do feel that they've set up an atmosphere here and a system that can absolutely compete for championships, ACC, and again, getting into the college football playoff. They think that they are set up for a while.
You know what I wish? There's an article, funny enough. Oh, it's Todd with the captains. Todd's with the captains. So let's get to Todd really quick, and we'll come back and talk about some other things. Hey, Todd.
Yeah, I mean, just a moment ago, Christian Wilkins was tossing out Krispy Kreme donuts. Now he's again waving at the crowd, smiling, having a good time. Hunter Renfro is doing the same. As you go on to the next Jeep Renegade, you're going to see left tackle Mitch Hyatt and starting linebacker Kendall Joseph. They're having a good time, smiling and just soaking this moment in. And you look back at Cleland Furrow. He announced earlier this week that he is going to indeed forego his final season of eligibility and enter the NFL draft. He will likely be a first round pick, perhaps in the upper part of that first round. But you know what? He's helped this team win two national championships. He is ready to move on to his next challenge. And what a special young man he has been. If you remember, after they lost to Alabama a year ago, a lot of the players didn't really want to go face the media. He walked up to Sports Information Director Tim Beray and volunteered. He said, Tim, I will do it. I will go speak to the media on behalf of my teammates, and I will face the music. We didn't play very well that night, but he was a stand-up kind of guy. And after the national championship win the other night, there he was, front and center, talking to myself and Fred Cunningham and others just about how wonderful it was, how wonderful it has been. He's ready for the next step as well. Let's send it back to you guys.
It's so awesome, Todd. You're doing a great job getting us such great interviews and perspective and seeing such great video of all the folks that people have tuned in to see and that are trying to see in person too. You know, they'll all head into the stadium. We're going to hear from some of the coaches, some of the players, mm-hmm. I think. And so when you watch the continuing coverage here on 7 News, you're going to get really a chance to kind of hear their final thoughts on this, right? This is sort of the wrap-up event that will close out this experience, and of course it'll live on for years to come. We'll all tell the stories, won't we?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, Dabo Swinney already has had his first meeting yesterday with the team to ready for 2019. Yep. So they've already started work on getting ready for, I think it's Georgia Tech they'll play in the Valley on a Thursday night in late August. But they're already thinking ahead of that. You saw a lot of those seniors and some of the other players who are going to be moving on to the NFL. They're going to start really concentrating on getting ready for everything that entails, the draft combine and all those meetings. So you're right. This is probably the last time really this group
will all be together
like this before they all start going their separate ways. Obviously, a large group of them will be here for next season. But,
sure.
Yeah, this is really it.
This is it. It's gonna wrap up and close out the experience for them. And I really think it's going to be fun to see what happens. Apparently, Hunter Renfro's playing catch. So, you know, that's always something worth seeing.
He's a great guy to play catch with because he's never, ever going to drop it.
That's right. He's kind of good at that. Yeah.
He has always been so dependable. Any Clemson fan knows from watching this team over the years. If it's third down and you need to throw to make a first down, you threw it in Hunter Renfro's direction, he was going to make the grab. I would think that he should hang out in hospitals and handle newborn babies because the most sure set
Never
of hands you could
one.
Find in the upstate.
That's right. That's pretty funny. You know, he's such a good young man, too, and he's a legend, right? No one will forget that final move in the previous championship. He'll live on forever. So now we are, of course, waiting to see what happens. And you see that slowly but surely the parade route's actually slowing down. And that's because, from what we understand, they have a process of getting people off and into the stadium. And it slows things down because they're actually having to stop vehicles, move people off, et cetera. That's great news for the fans down there, right? Because the closer you are to Memorial Stadium at this point, the closer you are to people being stuck in traffic, which means you get to play catch with Hunter Renfro.
Yeah. As you can see, they're making their way down. I believe now that is Fort Hill Street as they're beginning to make their way toward the stadium. But just look how deep they are. I mean, you're talking 6, 7, 8 deep right along there. And it can also get pretty close to all those players and those coaches as well. Again, Clemson celebrating today their third national championship in football, their second in the last 3 years. They've won 6 national championships as a university, but half of them have been in football.
It's so exciting for the fans to get to this moment. And it's really fun, too, for the younger kids. Like some of the kids who were, you know, won at the last championship are now able to kind of comprehend what's going on. And so for families to be able to share this with their younger ones and for people who are here who were here for 1981 and now they're getting to share it with their kids and their grandkids, it's very, very cool because you're seeing that sort of full circle experience happen where you're passing the tradition of national championships from generation to generation.
Absolutely. I mean, Clemson fans, again, they went 35 years between their first football championship and their second, and some of the names of those players, I mean, fans could spout off for years, and now what a huge list. You just think of the stars they had 2 years ago, you know, Deshaun Watson, Mike Williams, and then, of course, that's extended onto this team with Trevor Lawrence and Travis Etienne, Trayvon Mullen.
You know what we forgot about, though? They're going to the White House on Monday. So they will be together one more. I just thought of that. They will
right.
be going to meet with the president at the White House on Monday. And I'm guessing that most of those folks will make the trip and go to get that opportunity to do that really big celebration of having the president of the United States honor their accomplishments.
You are right. That invitation was just announced last night. Clemson said Monday evening. But you're right. So they will be together one more time after this, as Todd Summers has just immersed himself right here with all of these fans.
People
as they
the
make
trees.
Their way down.
They're even in the trees now. Those tigers are climbing the trees.
We'll do anything to get a camera picture these days, won't we?
We will. What? All right, so let's check in with Todd once again.
These
hey,
fans
Todd.
Are really starting to get excited. Hey, Amy, these fans are starting to really get excited. Dabo Swinney is coming by right now. We are about 100 yards from Death Valley where they're getting ready to run down the, well, probably walk down the hill. They're probably not going to run down the hill, but they'll walk down the hill and then
get ready for the next part of this celebration, which is going to be where some of the guys talk to the fans. Dabo Sweeney obviously will speak to the fans as well. And you just kind of look up here and you can see they're about four or five deep. We see some fans that are in trees to make sure they have the best view of what's going on. And then behind Dabo, again, you see Christian Wilkins and Hunter Renfrow as well. Got a couple young men that have footballs, hoping maybe that they can play catch like Hunter Renfrow and Christian Wilkins did a little while ago. They were playing catch with fans as they're riding along on the float. That just tells you how much they love what they do, how much they love this community, and just how a part of this community they are. There he is, Christian Wilkins, playing catch yet again. He's probably asking if he can score another touchdown. I know he's done that a couple times this year. We are getting closer and closer to being inside the stadium. Let's send it back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Todd. Right now, right around 10 o'clock on this Saturday morning, you are watching 7 News WSBA TV Spartanburg, and you're watching live coverage of the Clemson celebration here on the campus of Clemson University. I'm Fred Cunningham.
I'm Amy Wood. We're so glad you're with us. We've got a team of folks out there. We've had Christine Scarpelli, Christy Henderson, Todd Summers, who you just heard from. And of course, Air 7 is up today, giving you a view of Memorial Stadium that we couldn't show you any other way than to put Air 7 back up in the air for you today. And you could see, slowly but surely, we're watching the players and some of those older teams from years past that are slowly making their way down the hill, mm-hmm. coming on down like they used to. But they get to do it a little slower, right?
Yes.
It's not the 25 seconds, most exciting seconds. It's actually maybe a minute or two.
Yeah. Hey, we want to do something kind of fun right now. Paul Lamison right now flying in our helicopter Air 7 high above. First of all, Paul, good morning. Tell us what the view is from way up there.
Hey, how you doing? I am in Sky 7. We're flying over the stadium. Take a look. It's already packing up. Air 7, sorry. We're already packing out the stadium. Take a look. Look at all the people already in there. Gates opened at 7 a.m. and it's cold, but they're there ready to support this team. And we've seen a lot of great things throughout the parade from up here in the air. I'm going to pull out a little bit wide and show you. I mean, we watched the parade wind through the streets all the way into the stadium, and fans are moving in with the crowd as well. I'll push in and show you. Here's right where they're coming in. They're turning some of the cars away. The people are getting off right here. This is pretty much ground zero for the end of the parade, but the beginning of the big celebration inside the stadium. So it's a great vantage point up here. We're able to see everything, the parade, the players, the fans, and now they're starting to file into the stadium. Here, take a look inside. You can see the stage all set up. Some players are already down there. Some other people are down there. And the celebration will continue. And of course, you can see it live right here. Back to you guys in the station.
All right, so we've got a look at Dabo Sweeney now. Dabo Sweeney is moving his way through, getting closer to Memorial Stadium. And of course, this is a really exciting time for him to really see this thing come into the stadium once again, right? They finally are back home in their own stadium, Death Valley Memorial Stadium, where they just love to play football and have the Clemson fans rally them on.
That's right. They're back here, as you saw, Dabo Sweeney. Okay. Going by our Todd Summers a moment ago. He chatted very briefly while Dabo was moving, which is was a lot of fun. But you also saw from that Air 7 shot just a couple moments ago. Now they're beginning to get people up onto the stage right now. So they're right now right in front of the stadium, and they're making their way down, safely down the hill, as you mentioned. Yeah, I think some of those guys from the 70s, the 80s might want to not run down the hill, just sort of stroll
enjoy
down
it. Enjoy it. Yeah. Take it at a leisurely place. The knees are not what they used to be, right, after a few years.
They say it's the most exciting 25 seconds in college football. Maybe take a minute and a half to get down there.
2 minutes, yeah. That's awesome. All right, Dabo's family's with Todd.
Hey, we are joined now with Kathleen Sweeney. What was that ride like going through this fan base, feeling the love?
It was amazing. Dabo and I said this was even a better parade than 2 years ago.
just coming down the hill, it was amazing. The fans, everyone is so wonderful.
So many fans maybe weren't able to get out to California. It was a long ways away. How important is this parade for you guys to just say thank you?
That's what makes us feel so good, is that we can thank our fans who couldn't come to California. Thank you so much.
And the biggest fan of them all, Coach Sweeney, congratulations. Tell me what it's like to go through that crowd of people and feel the love.
It's surreal. I mean, you know, it's cold, it's early in the morning, but the Clemson family, they don't care. They just show up, and it's just packed. The route was awesome, too, coming down the hill here, looking at the stadium. I mean, it's just amazing. I'm so happy for our team that they get a chance to experience something like this. It's something they'll never forget.
You told us you had a vision of this many, many years ago. When your vision, did you have the parade as part of that?
Absolutely.
Or just the holding the trophy?
No, absolutely. We had the parade on the calendar.
For a year, he's
we planned the parade before it ever happened. Just finally we're able to execute the plan.
Lastly, now that you've had 3 or 4 days to let this group soak in, this special group of young men, how special they've been, what they've done, the foundation they've laid, how do you put into words Christian, Hunter Renfro, Cleland Farrell, Austin Bryant, that group of guys?
Yeah, they've changed Clemson forever. I mean, you know, 55 wins. I mean, they wanted to be the best ever. And they sought out. I mean, that was like, how many wins do we need? Well, you need 50. Well, they got 55. You know, it's just whatever. They went above and beyond in every area, academically and athletically. And so this senior group, collectively as a group, the depth of leadership was amazing. I mean, across the board, 26 guys got voted for captain. I'm just so proud of them. But they've changed Clemson forever and set the standard for all future teams.
Outstanding. Thank you, Coach Sweeney, very much. That man has helped change Clemson forever as well. Let's send it back to you guys.
We appreciate the coach taking the time to talk with 7 News today. Carolina's family, because we are very proud to be that TV sponsor, the TV official home of the Clemson Tiger family.
Yeah, 116 wins now as the head coach at Clemson, 116-30. And he took some of those losses just in those first 2 or 3 years as he was trying to get this thing headed in the direction that he wanted to. And obviously, it is working well right now, again, coming off that perfect season, the first 15-0 season in the history of at least modern college football.
Inside Clemson's Memorial Stadium, you can see the crowd is growing. That's the area where the players of the past and the current players, the national champs, will be coming on down. We've also had, of course, the other two champion teams that have come down and made their way into the stadium. So this is kind of the final hurrah right before they get this celebration inside the stadium underway.
It's going to be, and a lot of folks, again, the gates to Death Valley opened this morning at 7, and a lot of folks decided just to head straight there and actually watch the parade. They're watching our coverage right now on Paw Vision, you can see right there. But now that lower bowl is really beginning to fill up as you get more and more of the folks from the parade in there. Obviously, we just spoke to Dabo and Kathleen moments ago, and they were near the front, so you got about 4 flatbed trucks with really, really large guys wearing orange to unload and get them down the hill.
And then it's going to be
a pep rally.
Absolutely. Everyone said last time it felt like a football game in there, and I think it's going to feel that way again without all the action on the field. But it's going to be a really fun time and one that these fans are going to remember. It's really exciting to have the stadium audience with us. You know, a lot of those folks were in there as of 7 a.m., and at 7 a.m. they were replaying the championship game, which was really cool. So they got to watch the championship game, then the parade, and then they're going to have a live show unfold right in front of them there inside the stadium at Memorial Stadium.
And such a different championship game to watch. You know, when they were able to watch it 2 years ago, of course, it was all that tension. Well, you already knew the result, obviously, but all the tension right up to the end until 1 second ago when Hunter Renfro caught that go-ahead touchdown. This time, very, very, very different game in which they...
Yeah, well, you were in California. Yeah. I was here in the upstate, and I directly went to Academy Sports in Spartanburg. people had gone in the fourth quarter, start of the fourth quarter, to get in line at Academy Sports to get their national championship gear. They were that confident the Tigers had it in the bag and that this was going to be their champion game. And so they lined up and they watched the rest of the game on their phones in line doing cheers outside the various sports stores
That's
and apparel
crazy.
Stores. It was crazy.
That is crazy. It's
it
like,
is.
We got to get our T-shirts first. We'll watch the end of the game later
on the phone.
Because we got to get our shirts first. That's dedication. That's somebody who really wants a T-shirt. But
there
again,
was a mom. I got to tell you, there was a mom who had driven an hour to make sure that her children had championship shirts to wear to school the next morning.
Man, let's head back to Todd Summers. He has made his way inside Death Valley. Hey, Todd.
What's the end of the game floater?
Hey, Fred, we are inside Death Valley. The whole lower bowl is filling up as we speak. You can see thousands of fans that are ready to cheer on the Tigers as they get ready to come inside. If you look right now at the hill where the rock is, if you look up at the hill, you can see the players. Davo Sweeney is up there. Cleveland Farrell's up there. Christian Wilkins is up there. They're probably not going to come running down, but they're probably going to come walking down. Davo just touched the rock right now. You know, that is certainly a special feeling for Coach Sweeney. They stand on top of this hill before every single game. He rubs that rock before every single game, gets the crowd fired up, and then they come charging down, getting ready to face the next opponent. But today, there is no opponent. Today, it's all about a celebration of the first 15-0 team in the college football playoff era, the first 15-0 team in more than 120 years of college football. You can see Coach Sweeney getting the guys rocking back and forth with his wife. He is having so much fun. He is such a great coach to cover. Not everybody has as much fun as he does. Not everybody is as receptive to the media as he is. We are certainly in a great position. We are so grateful for all that he does for us and just how much easier he makes our job as well. We are live inside Death Valley, getting close to the guys getting up on the podium. Amy, Fred, let's send it back to you.